It turns out a lot of you did not know that you can wear wigs for more than a day. 5 days, in fact. It kind of blew your minds on both TikTok and Instagram, so I'm jumping here onto YouTube, a place where, to be honest, no one has ever asked. And I'm going to demonstrate to you exactly how I lay and install my wigs to last for me for 5 days without taking it off, and it's going to last while I travel, I shower, I sweat, I eat, I bathe. The whole lot. Let's get into it. So while there are many different ways to wear a wig and apply a wig, today I'm going to show you my absolute foolproof method that I always use anytime I'm going to wear a wig for a longer duration of time. To me, that typically lasts between 5 to 7 days. You can wear it for longer, you can wear it for shorter, but that sweet spot is kind of between those days. This is the wig in question today. She's beautiful. It is this gorgeous, gorgeous deep red color, and she is fresh. Normally, I tend to apply wigs that I've already cut the lace off because I've already worn them, but this one is fresh out the box, and most likely, if you're watching this video, you've also just gotten a fresh wig and have no idea what to do with it. So this brand new, out the box, nothing done to it except I've bleached the knots, which makes the hair look like it's growing out of your scalp. Bleaching the knots would just make your wig look natural. It doesn't have to be done on all wigs, but if you hold it over your hand and you see little tiny dots from where the hair is knotted into the lace, it benefits you to bleach it so that it looks more natural. This has been done on this wig, but otherwise, she's fresh out the box. This is what we're working with at the moment. This is my gorgeous hair color that I literally cannot get over. But the reason I'm actually going to be wearing a wig on top of it is because I'm going abroad to see Beyonce, and I wanna post a bunch there, and I don't feel like announcing this hair yet because at the time that I'm filming this, you guys don't know yet that this is my hair color. So we're wearing a wig to cover it up. Okay, I'm also traveling today, which means that it's very uncomfortable for me to travel with contact lenses, so I'm wearing glasses, and you already know it, they're by Zilul and Stella Cini. Me. Zilul is my absolute baby when it comes to spectacles and glasses, but I'm not about to be boring and have one style of glasses. I'm about to have 8. These are the ones that I've designed with them. This is my official collaboration with them, Stella and Zilul. But they also sent me a bunch more that are brand new on their website, so let's try them on together. These ones are adorable. Look at that detail. So if you're unfamiliar with Zilul, they are a really, really, really affordable brand when it comes to prescription glasses and sunglasses. Men, women, children, metal, plastics, or acetate. They have literally every single style, every single design, every single size, every single weight. If you're looking for stylish, affordable, and comfortable, this is the brand to go for. I've worked with them numerous times, and I've also released a collection with them, and today they are the proud sponsor of this video, and I could not be more happy because I literally only ever wear them. These are so fun. They look like I've got graphic neon liner. They do not miss. They genuinely do not miss. They can see everything that is trending right now on like TikTok and Instagram, and they just roll with it. To try something new, I also got these. They are probably a ballsier option, but they're also fascinating me so much. I love glasses, and I especially love Zilul glasses because they're always so fun. And saving my very favorite one for last, I'm so happy I got this. They're so gentle. They're so cute. They're so Pinterest. Look at them. Look, there's like a little space over here, so it literally gives that beautiful cat eye shape that I so love. I love them. They're to die for. I would die for these. I'm gonna be wearing these throughout the video, but I'm going to leave every single one of the 8 pairs of glasses that I just showed you down below, so that if you had a fascination with one of them in particular, it's going to be there. I'm also going to leave any coupon codes that you can use down the description box below, as well as all of Zilul's socials. So if you liked any of these, head over to zilul.com, try them out. You can even search them by name and get yourself a pair, or 7 or 8. All right, let's get into the video. I slept in this hairstyle last night because it was cute anyways, but it cannot stay under the wig, so let's remove it. Sexy. The first rule of wig wearing is that you need to flatten your own hair as much as possible. If you have short hair like me, it's going to make the process a lot easier, but if you have long hair, you need to flatten it as much as you can and as excessively as you can. using gels and sprays will get you there, but I would recommend if you have long hair, braid it up into tiny, tiny, tight braids and then clip them onto each other around this area of your head. If you put it up here, then the wig is going to have more volume, but if you want it flatter, I would recommend putting all your hair down here. I do need to remove my glasses for this. We're just going for super flat, like so. Such a cute look. Then you're gonna want to go on Amazon and look up wig cap, but you're going to keep an eye out for two things. The first one is that you do not want to get these mesh ones. These are good if you're going for a short duration of wig styling, but if you're going for multiple day wears, you're going to want to find the lace cap. And second of all, you're going to pay very close attention to the tone of the wig cap. This should match your own skin tone, your own skin color. They come in various colors. As you can see, they do come darker and lighter. This one is the one that fits my skin best. A question I get asked a lot when you wear wigs like this, are these one use only? Yes. We're going to see later on the video that I literally cut and trim this to my exact hairline, which means that when it then comes to remove it, you have to remove it and toss it. These tend to be quite cheap, and if you order in bulk, it does tend to absorb the cost in itself, but it's just something to keep in mind. Second question I get asked a lot. How do you protect your skin underneath? There is a considerable amount of product going on right now, and we're gonna layer on more, which means that our skin might react. I like to use a cuticle and beard balm. This is one by Yantra, and it does work surprisingly well to protect my skin. Now, you might be wondering that the whole point of a wig cap is that you wear it like a cap. In fact, it specifically comes with this elastic band so that you can reuse it. I'm gonna explain to you why you don't wanna do that. But first, you're gonna want to look really stupid for a little bit. Cut ear holes and poke your little ears out. Trust the process. Grab a bottle of hairspray. There are varieties that you can use. Most wig wearers will recommend the Got To Be Freeze hairspray because it is super durable. I ran out. We're using this. It works just as well. And now you're gonna do something that feels weird to do, but you're gonna have to do it. You're going to have to literally soak this through the wig cap through into your hair, because we're going to literally adhere the wig cap to our hair. One thing to pay kind of attention to is making sure that this is reaching the hairline. We do not want to stick this part of it, but have this part lifting. This is the most important. Go around the hairline and really layer it in. Now we're going to glue this and dry this onto our scalp. Very low heat, very low speed. Now it's time to cut. The reason that we go through this whole great length to gel down our hair and then spray the wig cap down and then cut it off is because this elastic band right here can get very, very, very annoying and cause the worst headaches ever. So when we're talking about durations like 5 days or more, that might become one of the biggest nuisances. In fact, before I used to do this, I could only stay on with a wig for around a day or two because it would be the most uncomfortable, painful process ever. Like this, however, we're taking off the very thing that is causing intense pressure around our hairline to cover it up. If you have a normal hair color, you can leave your hair like this, but I have Smurf hair color and I am melting through clearly, so I need to apply foundation onto this so that it... Dense brush, very light foundation. Once you've reached this stage, it is time for the glue. This is one called Ghost One. My hand is still full of gel. Give me a second, everybody. I got this from Amazon. before you go on and apply this all over, you have to do two things first. The first thing is you have to do a skin allergy test. It is literally said over here, patch test is required before use, because this thing is going to be on your head for a number of days. So you want to make sure that anything that you put on your skin for so long isn't going to cause an allergic reaction. The second thing is that this is solvent removable only, which means it does not come off with soap and water. You have to get something like this to remove the adhesive. This is another thing that I got off of Amazon. It's called extension remover. They're normally the same product that is used to remove the glue from tape-ins. It just kind of melts off the glue and makes it easier. So if you're gonna get this, this thing is going to make your wig last for weeks if you want to, but you need the appropriate remover for when it comes to removing the wig. I need to see what's on the I posted an Instagram video last time where someone told me to do two layers of glue instead of just one. The first layer completely dry to completely blur this line over here, and then apply a second layer for the wig, which was actually a very smart recommendation. If you have a smart recommendation for me or something that you want to try, you can visit my website, stellarihair.com, go to a section called House of Hair, and I've put in an area where you can leave your comments, suggestions, and ideas for me to try in my next videos. Wig tips, or what color I should try next, or anything else, you can leave it in the comment box over here. This hack makes so much sense. It's the first time I'm trying it today. Normally I just do one layer and that's it, but today I want to try it out to see if I can make this look as seamless as possible. That is probably the most seamless application I have ever done in my life, so thank you so much to whoever left me that hack. Now I'm gonna go in with the second official layer of glue. Now we can glue our wig. Start by detangling the wig. It's much, much easier to do it now than to do it on your head. I always like to keep down here very, very tight. I'm going to cut off the bottom lace. Let's glue this on. Now we cut off the excess lace and start styling. Cutting out the ear holes might be the tiniest bit annoying, but once you get it right, it's done. Look how beautiful it's looking. Oh my God. Just need get my ears available. I can make an eyebrow with that. That is beautiful. That is beautiful. Okay, that's one side completely done. Let's do the other. Ready for 5 days of wear. Honestly, I love, love, love this color. Love this cut. I gave it this really cute retro kind of a look because I'm like, if we're abroad, why not get a bit of sass to your look? And I absolutely love how it looks. And now this is going to stay on for the next 5 days while I travel and enjoy myself. And I don't have to worry about doing my hair. That is the whole point of doing this kind of long procedure, is that for the next 5 days, I don't have to worry about anything, because for the most part, once you style a wig, it tends to remain styled. And even if this drops, it's going to just remain sleek. The only thing I am going to take with me is a wax stick, because it does have quite a number of flyaways because they do make these wigs as realistic as possible. But other than that, I'm literally taking nothing but my hairbrush. All right, I'm ready to meet Beyonce. I feel like a receptionist from the 50s. All the tools that I used are going to be linked down below, but most of all of the glasses that I showcased in this video are going to be all individually linked, as well as coupon codes that you can use to get them even cheaper. If you're looking for quality styles, really stylish and really affordable, try out Zillow's immensely large collection. You're bound to find something that you like. You can get the prescription or non-prescription, and you can even get them sunglass style. I'm off now to meet Beyonce. If you haven't already subscribed to this channel, join the Stella fam. Let's learn a thing or two together. And as always, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll give it a go, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.